Hey, what up? This is Eddie04, and today we'll learn how to set up two controllers on your PC. Now, I've been asked multiple times how to set up more than one controller on PC for gaming. So today, we'll learn how to do that. Now, if you're just interested in setting up at least one controller, then go ahead and check the cards up here to follow through that tutorial. Now, if you want to learn how to set up more than one controller, then don't forget to smash that like button and keep on watching this video.
See, now in this case, I do not have another PS4 controller, so what we're going to do is we're going to use my PS3 controller, which I actually have a tutorial on how to set up a PS3 controller to work on PC. It works pretty well. You can go ahead and check the card up here. And we're going to connect also our PS4 controller to work on PC. So you know how's the deal. So I'm going to go ahead, and the first thing I want to do is go to control panel. And the reason why I want to go to control panel is because I want to make sure that my controller are going to be detected. So, and as I mentioned before, I'm going to show you how is it connected right now and what is the behavior that you'll get when you connect your game into it. And I want to go to devices and printers. Currently, I do not have my PS3 nor PS4 controller connected. So as you can see here, this is not connected and this is not connected. And I know that you would see an Xbox 360 controller for Windows there, and that is how it ends up looking when you follow the tutorial on how to set up your PS3 controller on PC. You can check it out in the description below as well. Now, currently, if I go here to properties, game controller settings, that is supposed to be my PS3 controller, but as you can see, it's not really responding to anything at the moment, and that is okay. That is how it was supposed to be. So
tell me in the comments below, which other controller you want to configure on your PC.
So currently, if I go to the game, I should be able to start the game, but I won't be able to do anything else. So the way the PS3 controller is set up currently is that it'll automatically be detected as a Xbox 360 controller, like if it was an X input controller. So in this case, I'm just gonna go ahead and plug it in. You can hear the little beep there. Now in this case, it's detected as a wireless controller. It doesn't even know if it's a PS3 or PS4 controller, just a wireless controller. And if I go here to settings, game controller settings, and I go to properties, when I start moving, you'll see that he is also taking inputs. But if I go ahead and start our game, you know what we always do to be able to test this out. I'm gonna go ahead and press buttons in the PS4 controller just because this is like my main tester. I want to use this as my secondary controller. Now remember, the PS3 controller is already being detected as an Xbox 360 controller, so that one will work. But if I try to use the PS4 controller as my secondary control, you'll see that nothing is happening. So I'll go ahead and press on the PS3. PS4, nothing. PS3, get in. So the first thing we're gonna test out is to try and play with two controllers at the same time. So I'm gonna go ahead and battle two players. Now I'm gonna go to my PS4 controller and press start. And it's not being detected as a secondary controller. So I'm gonna exit out of this game right away. And I'm gonna show you how to be able to set up the PS4 controller as the secondary control for gaming. So if you don't know how to set up a PS4 controller for PC gaming and take it as an X input controller, you can go ahead and check the card up here, which actually is a detailed tutorial on how to do that. So you already know how it is. I'm gonna right click on the game. I'm gonna go to properties, and I'm gonna go to local files. And I'm gonna browse the files. Now, for me, you can check the links in the description below. You can download the Xbox 360 controller emulator. Now, if you have any doubts or questions related to game controllers or streaming, you can go ahead and catch me out at Twitch, and you can check the link in the description below. All right, so now we are in the game folder, and we're gonna go ahead and run the emulator as an administrator. We're gonna go ahead and click on yes to allow it to install the drivers that it needs. In this case, we're going to go ahead and install the default DLL file just by clicking on create. Now, because we have both controllers connected, the emulator will detect each controller and go ahead and install the configuration for each one of them. In this case, the very first one that's been detected is actually our PS3 controller, even though it's showing up as Xbox 360. I already explained why. You can go ahead and check the links in the description below to learn how to use a PS3 controller on PC. Next, after that, when I finish here, it's now going to detect my secondary controller. In this case, it's my PS4 controller, which is also known as the wireless controller. Go ahead and click next. He's going to go ahead and download the settings for this controller. Now, right off the bat, both controllers should be able to work in any other game by just by doing this. But a few things that you want to go ahead and check just to verify and confirm that both controllers are going to be able to work on a game is going to the first tab, which is the controller, and you will notice that you have a couple of tabs in the bottom section here. You have general, access to button, advanced, and so on. So the first thing you want to make sure is to see that the name of the gamepad is being detected correctly. So in this case, Xbox 360, we know that it's our PS3 controller. The next thing you want to look into is the advanced tab. And in the advanced tab, you want to make sure that there's no combining option enabled. The same thing you can do if you go to controller number 2, which is our PS4 controller, you go advanced. The same thing you will notice that you also have the option for combining. So if I go to every single general tab of each controller, if I use my PS4 controller, it's going to react. And if I use my PS3 controller, is also reacts. Now, something else that you want to be a little bit careful is how the controllers are being mapped. How you can determine how the controller is being mapped, if you go into the controller tab and look into the name of each controller itself, you will notice that there's an option that says map to, and you have a drop down. Now, 0 is like the default option. Whatever is connected first will be detected and be assigned to each tab. But if you choose any of these numbers here from 1 to 4, that means that controller is going to be activated in that particular controller slot. In this case, controller number 1 is our PS3 controller, is on the default setting, so he's being detected as the very first controller. But I can easily change this to controller 4, for example, and it will actually reflect my settings and turn on that slot. So I'm going to go ahead and put it back into 0 so it can send it over to controller 1. And the same thing can be done for the secondary controller. Now, where can you enable or disable combining in the Xbox 360 emulator? By just going to options and make sure that under testing and login, the enable combining is disabled. That needs to be unchecked to make sure that both controllers are going to work. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on save. And as I have already explained before in other videos, when you save this, it all depends on every single computer. Each computer might be different and will react with different DLLs. You already know what is the list of DLL files names that you need to use for your computer. In this case, I know that mine will need 9_1_0 for it to work. Now, at the end of this video, I'll give you a bonus tip. If your controllers, even though you have set it up in the proper way, still do not react for your secondary player. And that's about it. I'm just going to go ahead and click on play to be able to load up our testing game, which has been Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm for the last couple of videos already. So you know that the very first test that I like to do is being able to send an input and actually exit out of the intro in the game. Now, because we have configured both controllers to be able to work with the Xbox 360 controller emulator, now I can easily send over my instructions from my PS3 controller into the game. Now, if you got this far and you attempt to start your Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm game, you have make sure that your controller 1 and controller 2 are connected correctly, that you have configured the settings in the proper way and they're mapped correctly, and you are still not able to play with two controllers at the same time, this is what you need to do. So close your game, load again your emulator, go ahead and check the settings in your controller, especially in controller number one. Go to advanced, make sure that where it says device pass through, disable it. Now you'll hear the beep. That means that he detected that there's another controller connected. Click on save. Load your game again. And now, enjoy. Oh snap, father, son.
Hey, hope you liked the video, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so that you can be notified whenever a new video is released. Now, go ahead and tell me in the comments below which other controller you want to configure on your PC. By the way, before you leave, don't forget to check one of our newest videos. Peace.